How safe are you really in a gated community? Is the safety real or is it supposed? The Netflix original series, Safe, leads us on a story of a missing teenage girl, her dead boyfriend, and some conveniently placed story parts. Michael C. Hall plays a dad who goes searching for his missing teenage daughter after a party where her boyfriend ends up dead. Safe is from author Harlan Coben, who also brought us the Netflix original series, The Five. Now, this is only 8 episodes, it's a serial crime drama, and it's totally bingeable in a day. Now, I enjoyed the story. While there are some unnecessary parts, and there's some parts that begin and then aren't totally resolved, and therefore making them unnecessary and just kind of filler, it held my attention. It was intriguing enough and it was engaging enough that I wanted to keep just hitting, yep, continue, okay, I'll watch the next episode. The actors are pretty believable in their grief, their anguish, and their anger. Michael C. Hall was pretty convincing with his British accent. He actually did it really well. Even the way that he pronounced some of the words that normally in Britain that they pronounce them this way, like privacy, he didn't even stumble on that. His mouth moved in a way that looked like it was natural, like he wasn't actually trying to be British, but that he actually was. So that was really good. Abby Abington plays another one of the characters, one of the main characters. You'll recognize her from Sherlock. She plays Mary Watson. She did an amazing job. This is a fairly large ensemble cast, and so you have a lot of stuff going on within the story. And so you have some things going on over here and some things going on over here while the main story is still going on. And what the author does is he uses some of these side stories to throw some red herrings in so that you keep guessing at who it is or what's going on. And you know what? It really does. It does a good job at keeping you guessing because I thought one way and some of it was kind of a little obvious. And so you guess a little bit of it and then others just kind of caught me off guard, and which was fun. I enjoyed that. That's what I'm looking for in a mystery, is that I don't want to know every single thing that's going on. I want it to keep me guessing. I want to be caught off guard because that means they're telling a good story and I'm engaged. I think the biggest problem that Safe has is that in the story, there are a lot of parts that are very, very convenient. Now, I can't get into what they are because it gives away a lot of spoilers, but suffice it to say that there are just things that normally wouldn't be placed where they are or happen as they happen, or just situations without it being totally contrived and only in a TV fictional world. In real life, a lot of these things wouldn't happen and wouldn't be going on this way. But we kind of forgive it because, again, the story is engaging. It's kind of fun. I enjoyed watching it, and I truly did want to see the next episode and the next episode. While I think it was fun to watch, I also think it's going to be forgettable in a few weeks. It was fun, but just not powerful enough to stick with you. There's a brief bit of nudity, no real sex, a ton of profanity, and some graphic violence. I give the Netflix original series Safe 3 out of 5 couches. Have you seen it? I'd love to hear your thoughts below in the comments. If you enjoyed this review, please give it a like and don't forget to subscribe. I'm Chris, this is Movies and Munchies. Thanks for couching with me.